Hello, my friends. I'm here with 1 Samuel, chapter 9, verse 1 through 11. Saul chosen to be king. There was a man of Benjamin whose name was Kish, the son of Abba, the son of Zor, the son of Bethroth, the son of Ith, a Benjamite, a mighty man of power. And he had a handsome son whose name was Saul. There was not a more handsome person than he among the children of Israel. From his shoulders upward, he was a tall than any other people. Now the dogs of Kish, Saul's father, were lost. And Kish said to his son Saul, "Please take one of the servants with you. Rise, go, and look for the donkeys." So he passed through the mountains of Ephraim and through the land of Shalish, but they did not find them. Then they passed through the land of Shulam, and they were not there. Then they passed through the land of Benjamites, but they did not find them. When they had come to the land of Zephah, Saul said to his servants who was with him, "Come, let us return, lest my father cease caring about the donkeys and become worried about us." And he said to him, "Look now, there is the city of a man of God. He is an honorable man. All that he says surely comes to pass. So let us go there. Perhaps he can show us the way that we should go." Then Saul said to his servant, "But look, if we go, what shall we bring the man? For the bread in our vessels is all gone, and there is no pleasant present to bring to the man of God. What do we have?" And the servant answered Saul again and said, "Look, I have here a hand, 1/4 of shekel silver. I will give that to the man of God to tell us our way." For merely in Israel, when a man went to acquire of God, he spoke this, "Come, let us go to the seer." For he who is now called a prophet was formerly called a seer. Then Saul said to his servant, well said, "Come, let us go." So we went to the sea where the man of God was. So Saul was going to find his donkeys with his servant because his dad sent him to find the donkey's servant and went all over the place. So he decided to go to man of God, basically, which is Samuel at that time. He was a prophet. They call them seers. But seers, why they're called prophets instead of seers is because seers are basically from the enemy. They're individuals that do the enemy's work. So prophet, basically, they were called prophets of God, because God would speak through them to give the message to his people. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and pray. Dear Heavenly Father, help this wonderful message reach people. Help accept Jesus Christ in their heart. Help them have a wonderful, blessed day today. In Jesus' name, amen. Talk to you guys there. Bye.